Have you created a Salesforce agent and need to train it? Well, let me show you how with Salesforce Knowledge Articles. Hey Jotformers, welcome back. I'm Kimberly, and like I mentioned, if you have already created your Salesforce agent and now you need to get it trained, you can either do it from scratch manually or you can do it with your Salesforce Knowledge Articles. So as of right now, you can see I have already chosen my AI agent, I've already connected it, and this is the very next step. So we need to choose which predefined skill set we would like to use. So you have six right here to choose from, and you can see each one, it says either actions or actions and articles. So if we look at case management and we look at the actions, we can see that it has the ability to verify customer, create case, get case by case number, and under articles, these are going to be the articles that are pulling from my Salesforce account. So let's go ahead and see what this looks like from this predefined, and then we'll come back and we'll look at it from scratch. So let's choose next. All right, so here is where we can look at our actions and our knowledge. So let's go ahead and start with actions. So we can see all the ones that were listed before. So if we need to see the action logs, if we need to edit it, rename, disable, or delete, we can do that for all of these by clicking on the three dots on the right-hand side. Now, maybe we want to add in an extra action. All we have to do is just click on add a new action. We get to choose what that action looks like, and we get to select the Salesforce object. And we need to identify when should this action run. Now, again, utilizing a template like this is definitely gonna help you out because it's gonna save you a lot of time. So let's go ahead and head back and let's look at that knowledge base. So right here, you can see all of my Salesforce knowledge articles that are in this. So if I choose this, let's go ahead and look at that summary, and we can see all of my articles. If we want to have it recrawl, we can, but let's go ahead and X out of this. Let's see what add a new knowledge looks like. We can search for our articles, and we can even search by type and status. And what is great is it can also search from your Salesforce knowledge articles that are in draft. Let's go ahead. I'm going to head back and one more time, and I'm going to disconnect so that way we can see what this looks like starting from scratch for that knowledge base. All right, so again, instead of choosing one of the predefined options, I'm gonna start from scratch, and you'll see that the actions and the knowledge starts out at zero. So we're going to have to add in everything ourselves. But let's look at that knowledge. So it says no knowledge yet. Let's add some new knowledge. So this looks very similar to what we were just at, but you can see all of the options here. So again, with the filter, we can choose to just see our drafts. We can choose to just see our published. We have one published, or we can choose to see everything. All right, let's go ahead and get these checked. And then we're gonna enable recrawling. We can choose daily, weekly, or monthly. So let's go ahead and save. All right, and now this looks very similar to where we were before. Again, if we need to look at that summary to have it recrawled or completely remove that article, we can do that from here. And it really is as simple as that. If you have any questions about how to train your Salesforce agent utilizing your Salesforce knowledge articles, let us know down below in the comments. If you like this video and you got some value, hit that like button and don't forget to subscribe and turn on the bell so you get a notification every time we put out a new video. I'll see you next time.